Casino from T-Mobile Arena. Just a beautiful day and night on the Strip. The Golden Knights in preseason game number 5. They host the San Jose Sharks at the Fortress. Take a look at Aiden Hill in net for the Golden Knights. He'll get the start. He and Logan Thompson expected to split the goaltending duties tonight. On the other end, Kaapo Kähkönen has played well against the Golden Knights as a member of the Sharks. And he gets the call here for San Jose. He was in net for the win for the Sharks against the Golden Knights earlier in this preseason. So for the second time in the exhibition schedule, the Nick Waugh line is the top line for the Golden Knights. They'll start it out along with Keegan Kolesar and Will Carrier. Ben Hutton and Braden Pahal on defense as Ben Hutton fires it in. Kaapo Kähkönen to play it around the glass. It got by Waugh, held in by Pahal, and his shot turned away by Kähkönen. Carrier throwing it towards the net, and Kähkönen able to find that with Keegan Kolesar providing some traffic in front. Preseason game number 5 for Bruce Cassidy's club tonight.
Yeah, he's seen enough of the kind of fooling around and working on individual games. He wants to see the structure and the things that he's implemented into the Golden Knights over his year and a little bit here at the helm.
Bruce Cassidy, who's said over the last couple of days, look, all the top players probably going to get maybe 2 of the final 3 preseason games, and most of their big guns not playing tonight. They'll be here against Colorado on Thursday, then over to L.A. for a Saturday matinee to win the exhibition schedule. This is year number 2 behind the San Jose bench for David Quinn.
Yeah, a real personable guy, excellent coach, won a Calder Cup in the American League with Cleveland before he made the leap to the National League. Started with the Rangers and unjustly clipped there for my money, and now doing a good job in San Jose.
Yeah, and Mike Greer, of course, Mike Greer, the GM of the Sharks. Second year that tandem has been in place in the Bay Area. Brendan Brisson will send it around the glass. Barabanov to play it up ahead. And the puck to neutralize to Philip Zadina. Signed a 1-year deal to come to San Jose after asking out in Detroit. Had 2 years left on his deal, but they terminated his contract. Set a real high pick, 6th overall pick in 2018. Looking for a fresh start in San Jose. Korzak to play it up ahead. Brisson took a hit as he banked it out. Now the puck up the wing, and Ty Emberson will gain the line. So the Golden Knights right now, Byron Fraze up front, along with Max Comtois and Paul Cotter. Cotter was talking earlier today about, you know, his last year's camp. He beat out some other players to earn a spot on this team right out of training camp. He's hoping to do the same again this year. Puck battle in the corner. Thomas Bortolo plays it to the line. A long wrist shot handled by Aiden Hill off the stick of Jacob McDonald as Aiden Hill makes his first stop of the night.
This is an example of a young player learning. Last game, along the wall, the puck came up and Brisson didn't get it out. He went to the bench. Dom Ducharme got in his ear. This time he takes the hit to make the play and gets it out. It's right in front of the bench. The head coach is watching. It's a good start for Brendan Brisson. Yeah, the little things.
We've seen Gary the last couple of years with Bruce Cassidy. If you're not responsible to play defensively, you're going to have a hard time playing at all.
Yeah, you have to do all the little things to play for Bruce Cassidy.
Off this faceoff, the Sharks control it. McDonald's shot got blocked out high by Comtois. And now McDonald will fire it in. 4 exhibition games down, 3 to go, including tonight for the VGK, as McDonald sends it in and Aiden Hill will cut it off. Talk about a lot of the moves the Sharks have made over the last year plus, shipping out some big money. They also traded a goaltender in Aiden Hill, and it worked out. Boy, did it ever work out for him and the Golden Knights. But there's a look at this San Jose group. Said missed the playoffs the last 4 years for the first time in team history, but I think for them this year, Gary, is going to be, you know, can they grow? Can they see some progress here? Obviously with the full rebuild underway.
Yeah, you said it, full rebuild. When Quinn and Greer took over, they had no prospects, they had no draft capital, and they had no cap space. They're trying to get all those things back right now. Trading Erik Karlsson was a big piece of getting the cap space. And they've also picked up some young players.
Morelli feeding it towards Annette. Demick got hooked on the process, so a delayed penalty here on San Jose. Hill to the bench for the extra player. Rempel in deep. The puck touched in behind the net. And the Golden Knights will go to the power play. Kyle Burrows goes to the box.
San Jose penalty number 4 has a 2-minute minor for hooking.
This is just a size penalty, Dave. Demick is 6'4", and he gets a little step on Burrows, and he's so long. When he gets his stick out there, the puck is a long way away from Burrows, and that he has to hook Demick to make sure he doesn't have a clean scoring chance.
Golden Knights to the power play for the first time tonight, sponsored by Adam Kuttner. Bruce Cassidy was talking the other day about execution and better structure in the entries for his power play unit. Puck deflected out of play as Will Carrier fed it towards the net. Said a lot of the players in the lineup tonight don't see a ton of power play time during the regular year, but these players will get a look in this game.
Yeah, well, absolutely. Opportunity. Maybe you do something that works here, and all of a sudden Bruce Cassidy, when he needs to change things up in the regular season, if things are stale, he remembers.
Golden Knights control this draw. Brendan Brisson playing one of the points on this power play with the wall line intact up front. Ben Hutton also on the top of the power play. Brisson in the middle of the wall. They got tipped away in the slot. Looks like Emberson got a piece of it. Now Waugh to dish it down to Kolesar. He'll turn and shovel it back to Waugh once again. So an early power play for the Golden Knights. Waugh's pass tipped out of the zone by Zadina. Hutton turns it back up the ice. Waugh shovels it down the wall. It's picked off though along the wing by Emberson, and the Sharks break up ice into the zone towards it out with Barabanov. Sealed off by Hill. I'll check it with Peterson on the move. Brisson gains the blue line. Cut off along the wall, and it's jammed out to neutral ice by Henry Thrunt. Golden Knights have clicked on the power play in each of their last two exhibition games. Jonathan Marchessault against the Kings recently, and then Brisson the other night. Rempel just missed the tip on the feed from Dorfiev. Cormier dishing it off. Rempel walks in, his shot, and Kakken to get a piece of that.
Rempel had 6 shots against Colorado in his last game in the preseason. He is a volume shooter, an American League version of Jonathan Marchessault.
Rempel will gain the line. Sheldon Rempel last year, real good year, 25 goals. Down at Henderson, tied Gage 20 for the team lead with the Silver Knights. Comtois looking to fight his way into the line. Kanishoff back to get it. That'll do it for the Vegas power play. And one shot on it. Hill digging in. Feeds it around to Fraze. And now Cotter carries it out. Just rolled off his stick. Swept around by Leon Gavanka. Gavanka will play it in deep. Fraze keeps it alive. Gavanka intercepts. And the puck to the wall. Morelli throws a hit. No score, just over 5 minutes into the opening period as Fabian Zetterl will play it in. Came over in that trade from New Jersey last year. For a big deal for Timo Meier. Caden Korzak starts it out. Puck tipped in deep by Demick. Kakken into play it around the wall. And the Sharks will push their way up the ice. Emberson into the offensive zone, throwing it on net. Hill handles it with a shoulder. Puck was loose to his right.
That was dicey.
Kolesar to play it out of danger.
Hill doing a better job early tonight at holding his position. Sean Burke, director of goaltending for the Golden Knights, tells us all the time, if they're going to beat us, I want the puck to go through the goalie. I don't want the goalie to be in the corner and have an empty net to shoot at.
Puck sent in deep by Quentin Musty, young player, 18 years old, first round pick for San Jose back in the June draft. Mahal, the hit on the corner on Giovanni Smith. Korzak and a work at Lewis. He got closed on right away by Peterson. Puck pinballs around to Korzak. Carrier dishing it off. And Mahal at the wheels. He'll start it out. Up ahead to Waugh. Waugh trying to absorb a hit from Burrows. Goes down on the Sharks on the counterattack. Zadina streaking in. And the puck's in right into the crease. Now a drive out high and a save made. Hill. Ivanka let it fly. He has it again. Wrist shot. Hill's lost a stick. Puck got blocked on the way in by Pahal. Dorofeev able to move it out, but good work by Aiden Hill in the Vegas net. Now Brisson on the wall. Lofted to Kanishoff. Ahak will send it in deep.
Good shift from Giovanni Smith of the Sharks. He was with the Panthers last year. He got into Will Carrier, got his glove up in Will's face. Will didn't bite. Then on the break, got right on top of Hill and banged into him.
Offside on the Sharks. 12:43 to go in the opening period. Some of the better chances in the game in the crease of Aiden Hill, who was able to hold the fort. The long rumored one of Erik Karlsson being moved out of San Jose. He heads to Pittsburgh in early August. And now from the Sharks standpoint, they only had to retain $1.5 million a year for this year and three more. So they freed up a lot of money, but they took some money on in that trade too.
Yeah, sort of half the work is done. He got rid of, you know, he only had to hold $1.5 million of Karlsson for over the next 4 years. So that's really good. But he took on $4.5 million, $5 million, $2.75 million in those three players. If he can move those players for draft capital or prospects and get that money off the books, then it's a really good trade for the Sharks.
Yeah, Erik Karlsson last year had a renaissance season for him. Top scoring defenseman of the game. Wrist shot from out high from Bortolo, blocked by Pahal. Now in deep, William Eklund. He'll play it back to the line, went off the leg of Kanishoff to neutral ice. Nikolai Kanishoff just hoping to stay healthy this year. He battled injuries. A young defenseman missed a good chunk of last year. He tore his Achilles 2 summers ago. Tore his groin the year before that. Missed all of 21-22. Battled some knee problems.
He plays hard. Plays hard and competes. He just hasn't been able to find any traction.
Back deep in the San Jose end. Ty Emberson back to get it. This came over on waivers from the Rangers on Saturday. Giovanni Smith tips it in. Ryan Carpenter on the forecheck for San Jose. Back with the Sharks again for Ryan Carpenter. In his first 5 years in the Sharks organization, of course, the Golden Knights grabbed him off the waiver wire in December of year one. Big part of the Golden Knights squad that went to the Cup Final in 2018. And going back to where it all began for him, his pro career in San Jose. Cotter up the wall, able to bank it a phrase. He backhands it out. Comtois providing a little bit of heat on Emberson. He'll make his way to the red line and shovel it down the wall. Shots are 5-3 for San Jose. Hutton in deep in a battle with Nico Sturm. Now Cotter on the wall with Barabanov. Able to fight his way to neutral ice. Burrows swings it across. McDonald with a lead pass into the middle. Sturm looking to center it. That bounced in on Hill. And he'll put a glove on it to hold for the faceoff. 9 minutes played now in a scoreless first period as Hill holds on.
Ryan Carpenter went to the Stanley Cup with the Golden Knights. He's been a few places since, Chicago, New York. Last year he had 25 goals in the American League with Hartford. He can still play at that level with a lot of success. Gets to the NHL and he's never been able to really score at this level, but works hard. And Gerard Gallant loved him.
Yeah, I took that year with the Golden Knights, right? Parlayed that into a 3-year deal with Chicago. Yeah. Ended up playing with the Rangers and
made over $8 million in his career now. And for a guy that looked like he was destined to play in the American League for his whole stretch, that's a pretty good chunk of change.
Faceoff in the Vegas end. Gage Quinney will take the draw. It's Jacob Peterson.
It's a big night for Gage Quinney.
A real good year last year with the Henderson Silver Knights. Tied for the team lead with those 25 goals with Sheldon Rempel. 10 power play goals. Career highs for him in all the offensive categories. Now Bischoff up the wall to Brisson. Little flip down the wing to Dorofeev with Quinney on the move. Dorofeev looking and defeated in the middle, but fanned on the pass. Jake Bischoff gains the line. Out back to get it is Oscar Lindblom. He plays it high around the glass. Zetterlin into the corner. Puck picked up by Lindblom. He'll bank it out to the blue line. Kanishoff shovels it in a little further. Leighton Ahak to pick it up. And now Pavel Dorofeev for Bischoff. Ahak turns it up ice. Battled some injury with it last year of the HSK. Played in just 34 games. And Leon Gavanka back on it for San Jose. Cormier to give chase. Lays it up the wall. Got picked off, but no damage done as Musty had it for a moment. Delayed offside on the Golden Knights. Gavanka with a lead pass on the money to Thomas Bortolo. Flying down the wing. Feeds it on net. Swept away with ease by Hill. Waugh the other way for Kolesar with Carrier and Cormier joining the rush. Kolesar absorbs a hit from McDonald. Here's Waugh. And a turn to the inside. Bortolo gave it right back to Waugh. Long wrist shot from Korzak blocked in front. Waugh picks it up. Lays it out to the line to Korzak. Wrist shot tipped wide. It was a high tip. Carrier tried to jam it into the side of the net. Puck held in by Korzak. He'll run it down to Kolesar. And the puck covered by the glove of Kakinen. 8:43 to go in the first at T-Mobile tonight. Golden Knights and Sharks. No score.
And didn't make the American Hockey League playoffs. That left players like Gage Quinney a long offseason. The last game Quinney played before this preseason was April 15th, which he admitted left some rust to shake off. He was able to fit in some summer skates over at City National Arena, where I'm told he was the MVP of the smooth skating agents. Three NHL games to his credit. He's looking to get back there again.
That's a long time, Darryl. It's almost 6 months.
Yep. Solid math.
Thank you. It's not an accident. I'm able to do basic arithmetic. Same guy, Garrett. There's a algebra one twice. That's me. 4x equals 12. X equals 3. Gary Gage Quinney said, coming off a real good year in Henderson, you know, also a real challenging year for him physically.
Well, the year before, he battled injury and he got what they call long COVID, and it prevented him from training at all the summer leading into last season. And he was gaunt, really, is the best word for it. This summer, he got to work out, got to, you know, set some goals physically. And he looks bigger than he ever has. And they call it man strength. And he's kind of, he's found it. And he really wants to be a guy that Golden Knights rely on for call-ups. And a night like tonight is a chance for him to convince Bruce Cassidy that he should fight for him if there's an injury.
Key part of this for a lot of players that might not make this team out of training camp, but if there's injury, if there's a need to call up a forward, a defenseman, leave the right impression in the minds of coaching staff, management. Okay, the Golden Knights with a younger look to their lineup tonight as the puck jumps the glass. A whistle with 7:40 to go now in the opening period. No score between the Golden Knights and the Sharks. Fans' partial season ticket plans are still available with savings over the single game price and special perks for members. Scan the QR code for more details. Of course, the regular season 1 week from tonight. One of the most special nights in team history. The Stanley Cup banner will be raised here at T-Mobile Arena. And Bruce Cassidy's talked a lot as the Sharks ice it here, Gary. I always find it funny that, look, every team that starts off every season has the same goal. Now, it's more realistic for some than others of winning a Stanley Cup. The Golden Knights and Bruce Cassidy, they talk about it openly that they expect to contend and they want to give it a real good run to repeat.
Yeah, much like he let them talk about winning the Stanley Cup during the finals last year, he said, well, we didn't talk about repeating right up until the regular season starts. Once the season starts, now they can dream about it at night, but during games and when we're working, we're in the present.
It doesn't think it's taboo to talk about winning back-to-back in a veteran group.
Look at what Tampa Bay did 3 years in a row, winning it twice, going to the final its third year, before eventually losing to Colorado. It'll all begin for the Golden Knights here a week from tonight. They'll host Seattle. Two most recent entries into the NHL. The Golden Knights will begin season 7. Hard to believe. 7 seasons here in the Valley.
Throwing up my lineup card the other day and put William Karlsson's age down 30. And I'm like, he was 23.
Right.
Yeah. He's got a wife. He's got a baby. They've got a baby.
Stanley Cup.
Oh, there's that too.
Yep. 6.5 to go in the first. Battle along the wall. Kolesar there. So was Lindblom. Out of the other side of McDonald and Carrier. Carrier gives McDonald a little shove. Kolesar starts it out to center. Able to move it in and stick a little pump from Emberson. Carrier walking in off to Waugh on the pass. Zinner skates. Waugh trying to keep it alive. Puck to the line. Chipped out of the zone. It got chipped around Pahal by Peterson. Quickly up ahead. It's Kolesar right back in. Feeds it across for Waugh. Waugh looking. Ahak couldn't quite keep that in. And delayed offside of the Golden Knights. That allows Burrows a chance to reset for San Jose.
What do you think Will Carey is saying to himself right now?
Had a good rush up the ice with Waugh. With a steal, Bordeleau trying to center it. Hill tips it away. Henry Thrun's shot. That's deflected wide. Henry Thrun's been good against the Golden Knights. Made his NHL debut against Vegas last year after 2 years at Harvard. Had 2 assists that night. Had a goal and 2 assists earlier in this preseason against the VGK. Hill cutting it off. He'll leave it for Cormier. Able to sidestep the forechecker and Eklund. Kanishov back on it. And around Borgabanka. Giovanni Smith to the Vegas line. 2-on-2. Cuts into the middle. Shot blocked away by Jake Bischoff. Cormier up for Morelli. With Demick on the rush. Morelli got stopped in his tracks by Emberson. That allows Ryan Carpenter to snap it in. Shots are 8-5 for San Jose. Still looking for our first goal of the night. Bischoff starting it out. Golden Knights' first road game of the new season will be in San Jose on Thursday, the 12th of October. Stern plays it around. McDonald gets his feet moving. Up ahead of Smith. Wrists it down to Hill. Handles it with ease and tosses it for Korzak. Now Ben Hutton. And here is Cotter. Paul Cotter saying earlier today he would like to think that spot in the left wing on William Karlsson's line is his. We'll see if it is or not. Do not discount the fact that he has to clear waivers. Pavel Dorfia would have to clear. Brendan Brisson does not.
Well, it might be Cotter's spot for game one, but I have a feeling it's going to be him and Dorofeev, and Bruce Cassidy's going to play carrot and stick all season with them.
Yeah, Bruce was saying the other day, this could play out for at least the first month of the season anyway. Thrun's pass tipped away by Pahal. Dorofeev trying to fight his way out. It's sealed off by Barabanov. And now puck back handed in deep by Zadina. Hutton starts it out. Quinney has to go off his stick to neutral ice. And Kanishov has it. As we approach 3 minutes to go in the first, Golden Knights haven't landed a shot in a little over 5 minutes. Lindholm will wind it in. And Hutton. In the second year of that 2-year extension he signed with the Golden Knights. Pahal to Dorofeev. The return pass blocked by Emberson. Quinney feeds it down a little further for Dorofeev. Out high to Pahal. Kept it in right on the line. Ahak looking. Shot off the outside of the net. Quinney back to Ahak again. And run it down. Behind the net it's Quinney. And a spin loose from Lindblom. Fights his way out in front. And Kekkonen with a good pad save.
on a good strong move to the net by Gage Quinney. Fought his way in front from the corner and Kakinen flashed out the right pad twice. Scripps Sports is sponsored by Palms Casino, a casino resort in Yamava Resort and Casino. By your Southern Nevada Toyota dealers, Toyota, let's go places. And by RC Willie, your home, your way. From the fortress tonight, the Golden Knights and the Sharks. No score. Will Carrier had a pretty good scoring opportunity his last shift.
Yeah, a real good look. He had a clean lane to the net. And he elected to pass it to Wah. I think that he went to the bench telling himself, next time you get that chance, we'll shoot it.
Will Carrier had 16 goals last year. Go along with a career high 25 points and the 16 goals. Career best for Will. Kolesar feeding it to Carrier behind the net, trying to stuff it home. Kakinen with a stick. Hutton out top. Puck never reached him. Took a strange kick off the boards. Into the zone comes Eklund. Cutting into the corner. Drive from the right side from Burrows, turned away by a Hill. And Kolesar with a high flip out of the zone. This will be an icing on the Golden Knights. About a minute and a half to go now in the period.
Will talked last year about his confidence, and last year he would have shot that puck. This year it's a clean look, and he goes almost in reverse and puts it in a place where Wah can never get to it. That's got to be an automatic. You're a power forward, put it on net.
McDonald back to play it for Emberson. Ben Hutton turns to get it. Battle for it along the wall. Carrier's there. Emberson, a long drive, tipped wide by Sturm. Jacob Demick picks it up. Held in by the skate of McDonald. Sturm in deep, looking out in front. Carries behind the net. And wheels it back out high for San Jose. Dishing it off to McDonald. He'll throw it towards the net. They got blocked wide. Emberson pinching in. 1 minute to go in the first period is sponsored by Credit One Bank. Carrier protecting the puck. Zadina in the neighborhood. So is Barabanov. Emberson out top. Wrist shot. And gloved by Hill. Some traffic in front of him. Zadina went down. But Hill took care of it.
Good work by Barabanov along the wall to get the puck loose. And the Sharks not afraid. Emberson gets the shot on net. And there's a few Sharks crashing. Ryan Carpenter, one of them, up on top of Aiden Hill. Vegas has not done a great job keeping people away from that blue ice tonight. That's something that Bruce Cassidy and John Stevens really worked on last year.
Golden Knights talked a lot about playing a goalie-friendly system, protecting their own house, tried to be pretty predictable where shots were going to come from. They ran through five different goalies. Quinney got stripped right before he could shoot it. And good work defensively by Justin Bailey. Now back into the zone comes Gavanka. Here's Smith. And a feed off to Carpenter. Smith with a wrist shot and a blocker save made by Hill. Good look for Giovanni Smith. Penalty on Vegas. Long wrist shot from Kanishaw blocked wide. This power play will come real late in the period for San Jose, but be a hook down low after Giovanni Smith had a good chance for the Sharks.
I can tell Giovanni Smith is fighting for a roster spot here to be in David
Vegas,
Quinn's
number six has a
lineup.
Minor for hooking.
Really good shot on net. See Bailey just lift the stick from Gage Quinney. Bailey's been around. He's a veteran, knows the game. Physical guy, hasn't played the National League in a couple of years. Vancouver, I think 2 years ago, his last time up.
Aiden Korzak had the hook on Bailey after Bailey made the good play at their other end of the ice. So, Golden Knights penalty kill, sponsored by Circa Sports. Sports betting the way it should be. Golden Knights have killed their last nine shorthanded situations in the preseason. Most of the San Jose power play, though, will begin in period two, as that's it. for period one. Shots were 12-7 in favor of San Jose. Neither Aiden Hill nor Kaapo Kähkönen beaten in that first period.
Yeah, a little scrambly period for both sides, but I have to like, if you're San Jose, you have to like the fact they were able to put 12 shots on the net. They had some chances, and they were able to get to the net. The best chance for Vegas was Gage Quinney when he came out of the corner and showed that power we were talking about to get right into the slot, and unable to beat Kähkönen, but a real nice play.
Coming up on the Jack in the Box intermission report, Darren will chat with the Golden Knights' Will Carrier, and then it's Ashley. And Golden Knights and Sharks at the regular season just over a week away from tonight for the Golden Knights. No score after 20 minutes. Not a ton of chances on the offensive end for the Golden Knights. On the defensive end, Aiden Hill was real good in that first period.
Yeah, shot attempts were 26-11. He was busy, and he had people on top of him a lot. And that's sort of, you know, something you want to get used to is having that traffic around you. You don't get it in practice. No one's bumping you then. Giovanni Smith was all over Aiden Hill, and we're starting to see Aiden that he can really kick those pads out as well in right, the right situations. Was fantastic in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and he's picked up right where he left off in this one.
Take a look at our numbers through the first period. We've adjusted the shots a little bit. It was 12-7, now it's 11-6 for San Jose. Golden Knights did not click on their power play, and as you see, the Sharks have pretty much a full one here to begin the second period. But Aiden Hill expected to play the first half of this game and then give way to Logan Thompson. Still some time in the box for Caden Korzak. He got called for a hooking minor late in the first period. So the Sharks to begin the second on the power play, and they Will Carrier and Nick Waugh up front on this penalty kill along with Braden Pahal and Jake Bischoff. Power play unit for San Jose with Bortolo up front, joined by Bailey and Musty. And Thrun with Eklund on the points as Mike is cut off by Kähkönen. So Henry Thrun to start it out. Well, back pass to William Eklund. Seventh overall pick for San Jose in the 2021 draft. Thrun has it out top and around the horn. Musty feeds it across. Bortolo holding. Out high it's Thrun. Musty trying to center it, pass block. Carrier and Pahal were there, and the Golden Knights able to clear it.
Musty from Hamburg, New York, plays for the Sudbury Wolves in the Ontario Hockey League, and you betcha he picks apart a few penalty kills with that vision off the sidewall.
A young kid, just 18 years old, and his pass picked off to try to snap it across. Thrun will reset. It's under a minute to go in this carryover power play for the Sharks. Thrun walks the line to his right. Head up, dishing it. Got it back from Eklund, a one-timer. It's blocked in front. Hill was able to turn that away. And the puck cleared by Kolesar. No, Kähkönen will leave it deep in his own territory. McDonald with a drop pass. Zadina starts it out. Into the zone with Peterson, a little give and go. And Peterson gets stopped in his tracks by Pahal. Barabanov on the far side of the ice. A couple of steps down the half wall, banks it to McDonald. Wrist shot blocked. Bischoff got a piece of it. McDonald around for Alexander Barabanov. Time ticking away in the San Jose power play. Philip Zadina. Jacob McDonald. Korzak out of the box. One timer. Stick explodes. On Zadina, up ice Korzak, out of the box, and a save made by Kähkönen. He was being chased by McDonald. Caden Korzak with a good chance. San Jose did not land a shot on the power play. Ahak moves it up the wall. Through center ice, Morelli, his pass intercepted. Ivanka back the other way. Hill feeds it around the boards. And Byron Fraze to start it out, a backhand feed towards Paul Cotter. Puck sent back the other way, and Ben Hutton to give chase. ahead of Justin Bailey. Connor looking to jam it out. Partially blocked, but now Frazee picks it up. Into the zone against Kanishov, and his wrist shot gloved by Kakinen. And he'll hold it.
Korzak hops out of the box and good vision to flip that puck up to him, and he gets it to settle and shows you that excellent footwork. He's a great skater. Pahal said this morning, I want to be more physical. I've used the first couple of times I've been in these games to get my timing. My timing's there. I want to hit people tonight.
Now, Braden Pahal last year played 10 games with the Golden Knights, most of them from the middle of December into the new year, and played in the next to last regular season game in Seattle. Part of the extra players, the Black Aces throughout the playoffs, has his name on the Stanley Cup. Puck below the goal line. Brisson there, so is Emberson and Barabanov. Among others, Quinney comes away with it. Emberson gets it back up ahead to Zadina. Lead pass to Sturm at center. And Korzak to give chase ahead of Barabanov. Digging it out, Zadina plays it out high. Emberson shot tipped wide by Sturm. And the rebound chance. Barabanov was there. I don't know if Hill dove across or if Cormier got a piece of that puck. Barabanov gains the line. Puck down the wall to Pahal. Well, you think you see Aiden Hill dive back like that. Flashbacks of the save on Nick Cousins in the Cup final.
Yeah, Nick Cousins will be having that flashback the rest of his life. Not a happy one for him.
Law provides the heat on Kanishov. Kanishov, they're able to regain possession and play it to Eklund. Lead pass out of the reach of Musty, so that allows Hutton to wire it back in. Ivanka plays it around the wall. Musty, nice little pass between the legs of Bortolo to the red line, and wedged out of the play by Carrier. Hutton feeds it back to neutral ice. Bortolo's pass partially blocked by Carrier, and Pahal swings it out. Kolesar and Waugh on the move. Kolesar driving wide, rolls up. Turns towards the blue line. The feed to Bischoff went to neutral ice, so the Golden Knights will have to clear everybody out of the offensive end. And Quentin Musty deep in his own end. He'll start it out. Up the middle, pass deflected in deep. On the redirect with Jacob Peterson. Remember the trade deadline from Dallas last year. Lindblom tried to tip it and sent it off of Bischoff. And out of play. It's about 5 minutes played in the middle period.
Flurry of chances and comes right here, and Hill gets his stick on it, or is it Cormier maybe blocks it. Aiden was there, and you're right, it was going to be pretty it was going to be pretty reminiscent of his stop on Cousins, but Cormier got in the way.
Good work by Lucas Cormier to get a piece of that puck
during the Stanley Cup final. All these media comes in from other places. They haven't seen the Golden Knights play regularly. And they were all, you know, saying, well, it's Aiden Hill, it's Aiden Hill. And, he, you know, it's not going to last. He's going to, sooner or later, he's going to crack. And then, you know, midway through the series, it was like, well, midway through the series, after game two, it was like, well, he hasn't really had to do a lot. And I'm like, come on, what about the Cousins save? Give him credit. Yeah. Aiden Hill has a reputation of just being a shot blocker. Well, what we saw in the playoffs last year is he can rise to the moment and make the big save.
Came in game three of that Edmonton series for the injured Lauren Brossoit. Only allowed 12 goals in the five games of the Stanley Cup final.
Could have won the Conn Smythe.
No question. Golden Knights had a better than a handful of players in the running for it. Earned himself a 2-year deal to stay in Vegas. Didn't get to free agency. A little shy of $10 million. Puck sent towards Hill here, and he's able to cover it. And hold on. Comtois and Smith. The gloves up a little bit.
Smith's been trying to stir things up all night. That's his job. Good work along the wall by Bailey. Backhander, and there's Smith again right in front of Hill. Aiden gets his, stops it with the pads and then gets his glove on it quick. He's composed. Smith and Comtois with a little jousting.
Off this faceoff, Kavanka's wrist shot blocked. San Jose, just one exhibition game left for them. They'll be in Salt Lake City to play the Kings Thursday. That game that Golden Knights have played the last few years. Quinney with a wrist shot. That got blocked by Zadina. And the Sharks don't start until next Thursday. So they'll have a week between their final exhibition game and the start of the regular season.
Now they might not want to start, though, knowing what the start of their schedule is like.
It is brutal. Zadina gains the line. Gavanka shot. A blocker save made by Hill, and the rebound cleared.
Gavanka, the German missile, they call him in Winnipeg when he played for the Manitoba Moose. 21 goals last year.
Here's Korzak deep in his own end, hard around the boards. Got blocked in the corner. Bortolo able to feed it down. Eklund trying to pull free. Spins back behind the net. Blasts it to the short side. Score. A nice look to Thomas Bortolo, set up by William Eklund. And Bortolo buries it from short range. It's 1-0 San Jose.
Yeah, this is why Eklund is such a high pick. Shows you his ability to elude and shake a check and then know that he's going to have someone backdoor. Threads the needle. Perfect pass. Bortolo shrugs his shoulders after it comes to him out off the wall. This is really fancy, Dave.
Beautiful pass by Eklund.
Yeah.
They're just 20 years old. And most of last year, the San Jose Barracuda at 41 points in 54 games. Cup of coffee with the Sharks at 2 goals and an assist in an 8-game span with them. But he set up Thomas Bortolo. They both had good seasons playing for the San Jose Barracuda. Bortolo at 22 goals. And it's 1-0 San Jose at 6:51 of the first.
Bortolo, the son of former NHLer Sebastian Bortolo.
Run zips it up ahead. But chipped in by Bortolo to the corner. Musty on the forecheck. Puck jumps the glass for a whistle. We'll step aside with 12:36 to go in the first. Bortolo from Eklund gets San Jose on the board.
In hockey, Keegan Colasar and Will Carrier both producing career best goal totals last season, but the guy in the middle is what seems to make it all work. Nicholas Watt scored 14 goals last season, 15 the year before, chipped in with 3 in the Stanley Cup playoffs last year, and it is assumed that it is one of the great trades and acquisitions in Golden Knights history, picking him up from Carolina, culminating with a Stanley Cup, guys.
Yeah, at the time, Darren Ryder was for Eric Hallow, who had that bad injury here with the Golden Knights in year 2. Nick Waugh, fresh off a Calder Cup in the AHL, a good young player the Golden Knights were able to acquire in that deal.
Yeah, well, the Chicago Wolves, who were the Golden Knights affiliate at the time, they played the Charlotte Checkers in the Calder Cup final, and Golden Knights pro scouting staff.
Puck sent towards the net. We got bat of the way of the goal mouth by Gavanka. Now Hutton will carry in further. Move it to Weig. A double teamed in deep, trying to run it back to the line, but that could deflect it out of play. And 1-0 San Jose here in the second.
The Golden Knights pro scouting staff, they watched that whole series. And in particular, Waugh was taking all the draws against Cody Glass. And he won every draw. Nick Hague said in front of Cody, we couldn't get the puck. And Cody's like, thanks a lot. That was me. And, but he wasn't the only one thinking that. And the Golden Knights pro scouting staff, they decided, we like this kid. He played for Canada in the World Juniors. Kelly McCrimmon was familiar with him. They made the deal.
Nick was also saying, we had no answer for him. As that series went on, we couldn't. Wasn't much we could do against him. Smith just ran over Cormier. Yep. Physical tonight, as he usually is, Giovanni Smith. Puck pinballs around and into the zone comes Carpenter. His wrist shot blocked out of play by Cormier for a whistle.
Smith couldn't get in the lineup for the Panthers in the Stanley Cup final, and then he came over to San Jose in the offseason, but he's a lot bigger than Cormier, and Cormier is trying to spin there and to make a move, and Smith just kind of envelopes him.
Game high 4 hits for Giovanni Smith.
He's been good.
And a couple of players come over from that Florida team that went to the Cup final. Of course, Anthony Duclair not in the lineup tonight, but remember the Panthers last couple of years missed a good chunk of last year and an Achilles injury in the offseason. Morelli in the corner with Rempel and Demick up front. Borzak and Bischoff on defense. They try to jam it loose in the corner. Rempel, Morelli's down. Demick has the puck. Runs it back down to Morelli, who's on his feet now, trying to fight his way in front. Puck loose on the goal mouth. Kähkönen finds it. And then Morelli wrapped up by Gavanka. He made a strong move to the net. Did Mason Morelli.
Did he ever? He just decided, I'm getting there, and no one could stop him. Comes out, one hand on the stick, goes right to the net. Does it go in? If it did, he kicked it in. You can't see if it crossed the goal line from the first angle that we got, but if it did, there was a distinct kicking motion.
Yeah. San Jose minor penalty to number 54. 2 minutes for roughing.
Might have been a little extra polish after the whistle from Giovanni Smith.
Yeah.
He goes to the box.
I don't think it went in. I think Kähkönen got that pad out there, sealed it, did a real nice job.
And you see Smith continuing to give Morelli the business.
He should. That's, you know, the guy goes to your goalie like that, and you're trying to make the team. You've got Mike Greer and David Quinn watching you. They're like, okay, this guy's going to protect our goalie. You get a check mark for that. Morelli had a real good playoff for the Hershey Bears in the Calder Cup playoffs last year and got himself a championship. Hershey won the final.
Out of Nebraska, Omaha. Golden Knights to the power play for the second time tonight. Waugh, Carrier, Colasar with Brisson and Hutton. Carrier feeding it down to Colasar in deep. Coming up on 11 minutes to go in the second. And the Golden Knights looking to tie the game. Brisson, a couple of goals here in the preseason. Carrier cutting in, dishing it off to Waugh. He'll turn along the wall. Out high, Hutton. Brendan Brisson, the only Golden Knight to score more than once in the exhibition schedule. He did that playing on Jack Eichel's line. Colasar on the forehand, blocked down low, and the puck cleared as Sturm's clearing attempt just glanced off the skate of Hutton. Brisson had it chopped off his stick by Sturm, and back to get it is Ben Hutton. Sharks last year were 8th on the penalty kill. Colasar gains the line. Golden Knights season ago were led by 9 power play goals from Jonathan Marchessault. So one front and a glove save. Kähkönen, after Cotter threw it in front from the corner, it eventually made it to Waugh for a good look.
Right in the slot, great work. Just Kähkönen is big, doesn't give Waugh very much to shoot at. And then he responds real nicely after. Logan Thompson comes into the net for the Golden Knights. Aiden Hill leaves, having stopped 14 of 50. Not bad.
And Logan Thompson comes in with his team on the power play still for 55 seconds. Sheldon Rempel, Byron Fraze, and a drive from Dorothea blocked.
Dorothea's shot is underrated, Dave.
Yeah. He really caught lightning in a bottle last year. Late in the regular season for the Golden Knights. 5 goals in 7 games. 7 in 10. Denishoff wrists it all the way down. Dorfiev back on it. Carries it to the red line. Over the blue line and lost it. And an easy clear for Jacob Peterson. 10 seconds in the clock running on the Vegas power play. Rempel over the blue line. Hope checked away though by Thrunt. And now Fraze turns back. So the Golden Knights 0-for-2 on the power play. They've had one shot on each of them. Burrows plays it up the wall. Held in by Cormier. Snaps it for Comtois. Just topped on the ice. He got bumped down by Lindblom. Run up the wall. Smith trying to tip it out, and he does to neutral ice. Korzak's clearing attempt block. Peterson breaking in on Thompson. A backhand and a save. Thompson. Yeah, slash. Well, Logan Thompson coming on to play the second half of this game, and the first chance he faces is a breakaway from Jacob Peterson. But Thompson stayed with it. It'll be Caden Korzak to the penalty box. Two for him. So the Sharks have one more exhibition game. It'll be in Salt Lake City against the Kings on Thursday. Then they don't play for a week. Their first game is the Golden Knights' second game on October the 12th. Look at that homestand to begin. Colorado, Carolina, Boston. Then they head east, and it's actually for five. Nashville, Florida, Tampa, Carolina, Washington on that trip. So right out of the gate, the rebuilding Sharks will be tested early and often.
What did he tell us? His father told him? Nobody cares.
Yep, nobody wants to hear it.
Nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
If your schedule is hard or what, why your record is why it is, it is what it is.
That's right.
Nobody cares. Mr. Quinn to his son, David.
Truth.
Dave, nobody cares.
Yep, that's right.
You got to work with me instead of Shane.
I was going to say, we all have our challenges.
Nobody cares.
Power play number two for San Jose after Korzak and a chop on Peterson on the breakaway chance. Barabanov into the zone and a feed it up the wall. Carrier there, so is Bischoff. And the Golden Knights able to clear it. Jacob McDonald will start it out. Now Zadina for Barabanov. Into the offensive end. Puck around the wall for Zadina. McDonald feeds it. Gavanka looking. His shot went up over the net. Thompson may have got a piece of that with a stick. Gavanka a little touch pass down the wall for Zadina. Short feed to Peterson. Barabanov. A timer for McDonald. He scores. Big bomb for Jacob McDonald. Power play goal, and the Sharks have struck twice in the second period.
Good movement from the Sharks. Zetterlund is kind of buzzing around Thompson. And then this is just a hammer from up top from Jacob McDonald. Gets it all. Gets it in one clean fell swoop upstairs just under the bar. Not known as a power play guy, but with, well, with Erik Karlsson in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
And Mario Ferraro not playing tonight. There's an opportunity.
And the 30-year-old veteran ripped it home. Power play goal. Golden Knights had killed off 12 straight here in the preseason. That comes to an end. McDonald at 12-11 to make it 2-0 San Jose. San Jose was near the bottom of the league in the power play last year at 25th, but able to grab a 2-0 advantage on the power play goal from Jacob McDonald.
Started last year in Colorado and moved over to San Jose.
Pucks that dim from the line and Thompson gloves it. McDonald goal from Barabanov and Zadina. To make it a 2-0 lead. And Bruce Cassidy's talked the last couple of days about as they get going in the regular season, they realize his team is going to be a measuring stick game for a lot of teams.
I asked him, we had him, Dan Dubin and I had him on a radio show yesterday.
Kanishov rips it wide.
And he asked him what it was like to be now being the hunted every night. He said he spoke to John Cooper about it and Jared Bednar. Cooper back-to-back Stanley Cup wins with the Lightning, and then Bednar won with Colorado and picked their brains on what to expect and how to handle it.
No easy nights.
Neither of those guys, well, Coop defended once, but both of his wins were COVID wins, kind of short seasons, and a little different. Bednar went the distance, and then last year was not able to repeat.
And the Golden Knights pretty confident they'll be able to handle it well. They do have a veteran group.
Yeah.
So many returnees from a year ago.
One and guy that they can lean on, Dave, is Alex Pietrangelo.
Yep.
They won the Stanley Cup in 19, and then the next year they were in first place in January, and then kind of faded once COVID hit.
Smith looking, he centered it. I got tipped away. And they've got Pietrangelo, who's been through it before. This will be the third time Alec Martinez going through this.
Yep. Stevenson's won.
Yeah. Trying to defend the Stanley Cup. The Golden Knights have talked a lot about focusing on the smaller picture, and you've got to get there first, be a playoff team, love to win your division, but it's a long, long way from October to June. McDonald with a wrist shot, turned away by Thompson. Hutton has it now. Morelli trying to move it out, held in by Henry Thrun on the pinch. Now Barabanov jumps ahead of Morelli to keep it in. Now the Sharks scored twice here in the second period and looking for more. Barabanov out high, knifes his way in behind the net. Still has it out top. Morelli with an eye on him. Barabanov has it on a string right now. Takes it all the way behind the net. Pass picked off by Rempel, and he'll shovel it out. Morelli to the red line and in, and the Golden Knights complete a change up front and on the back end. Nick Wasline hops out. Zadina got a piece of that to tip it in deep. And here's Bischoff. As we hit 5 minutes to go in the second, Bolesar with some room with Carrier coming. Bolesar driving in. Good work by Kanishov. Bischoff lets it rip and a glove save. Kakinen scooped it up at ice level. Kaapo Kakinen with the glove. 4:51 to go in the second. Jake McDonald on the power play to make it 2-0 San Jose. On Saturday with the passing of Chris Snow, the assistant general manager of the Calgary Flames, native of Melrose, Massachusetts. Chris was given 6 to 12 months to live when he was diagnosed with ALS in June of 2019. He battled it for over 4 years. A phenomenal sports writer earlier in his career. Covered the Minnesota Wild for the Minneapolis Star Tribune, covered the Boston Red Sox for the Boston Globe, and then an invaluable member of the Flames staff. And we are thinking of his wife Kelsey and his children Cohen and Willa. Hard to believe that a family could be so decimated and devastated by a dreadful disease of ALS, but we remember Chris Snow tonight. Father Bob was a heck of a sports writer as well. Covered the Boston Bruins. Chris lost his dad, two uncles, a cousin, and then he also battled ALS as well before passing on Saturday. Here's Nick Waugh. Cotter takes a bump. Kanishov. And Eklund will lay it back. More musty. And offside here on San Jose. And a whistle, just over 4 minutes to go now in the period. Now, Bruce Cassidy's talked a lot, Gary, but he's not, preseason is what it is. Not too preoccupied with results, but you want to see good trends as you close in on the regular season, which is going to be here before we know it.
And he's starting to get frustrated. You can see it right now. There's a lot of mistakes tonight. It's been a pretty uneven level of execution from the Golden Knights. And if you're trying to earn a spot, and Comtois has not popped off the page, neither has Cotter for that matter.
Mayhack moves it across.
Graves will play it in. Paul Cotter has one shot tonight. Max Comtois does not have a shot on net. Has the puck here at center. Here's McDonald. 3.5 to go in the middle period. And with a steal, Cormier turned it over, couldn't get it out. And a wrist shot from Zetterlin deflected out of play. 3:17 to go now in the second. Sharks up 2-0 in the middle period. Fans of Henderson Silver Knights represent the future of the VGK. Head to Henderson and see them forge the night. Get your tickets today at hendersonsilverknights.com.
And all things being equal, my guess is it's a battle between Cotter and Dorofeev to who's going to play on the left wing on Carlson's line on opening night. And you know, maybe they each get one of these last two games to try and show what they can do playing with it. Because I don't know how you handicap it right now.
Dorofeev held without a shot as well so far tonight. Drive from out high from Hutton sails over the net. Korzak feeds it around. Brisson trying to protect the puck on the wall. Quinney's there too. Puck trickles to the corner to Thrun. Carpenter dishing it off for Thrun right down the middle. Pulls up. And Thompson will cover and hold for the faceoff. 2:35 to go in the period. We expect, Gary, that you get two games to go in the exhibition season, Thursday and Saturday, and you'd expect Aiden Hill to get a complete game, Logan Thompson to get a complete game, and then go from there. Bruce Cassidy has said he doesn't think either goaltender is going to play a lot more than the other. Why would you? It's not really the trend right now, and hasn't been for a long time in the NHL.
Yeah, to me, you know, it's the secret to success. You know, you look at Tampa, sure they won two Stanley Cups, but they've been redlining Vasilevsky for a long time. And now, you know, he's got a back issue that's going to keep him out for at least 2 months. We see it in Winnipeg every year. Connor Hellebuck plays, you know, nearly 60 games, and by the time we get to the playoffs, he doesn't have anything left.
Puck into the San Jose bench. We mentioned what's ahead here for the Golden Knights. An hour-long pregame show coming up for that season opener on the 10th of October here. Our friends at ESPN will have that game. But before that, we've got TNT here Thursday for Colorado. We'll be with you for the final exhibition game in LA on Saturday. And then our regular season coverage gets going after that hour-long pregame show for the home opener, and the banner-raising ceremony will be with you in San Jose. Get things going on Thursday. With Barabanov. He got bumped down by Waugh, but puck ends up in the stick of Kanishoff. Now into the Vegas zone, Bischoff flips it high to the offensive end. And Kanishoff with 1:50 to go in the period. Eklund breaking in, shot, save made by Thompson. Rebound to McDonald. Eklund in deep, trying to cut his way in front. He ran into Pahal.
Eklund has shown some real offensive flashes. He's got some offense in his game.
Dorofeev looking to move it out. Bortolo keeps it in. Dorofeev again. This time Quinney will kick it out. McDonald winds it in deep. Tried to, but that went over the glass.
Bortolo. It's a great hockey name.
Terrific.
You like it because it rhymes with Bordeaux.
Don't mind the occasional red.
So I got to ask you, there's quite a bit of Rhode Island in the game tonight. David Quinn is the native of Rhode Island. You are too, and you both have just you have houses there.
Right.
Taylor Swift has a place there. You're a musician. Like, do you get to go over to Taylor's and
and
jam?
No, Taylor would not want me over there. She'd call the cops. Who's trespassing? David Quinn's in the high rent district of Westerly, Rhode Island, where Taylor Swift is. All reports are he's building one heck of a home right on the ocean. Why wouldn't you? If you could do that for yourself in God's country. There's Lundblom trying to center it. Taylor's been busy lately. One to go in the second period, brought to you by, sponsored by Credit One Bank. All around Travis Kelce. The door field. Quinney gains the line. Off to Connor, back to Quinney and Kekkonen. His best save of the game. Half a minute to go in the second. One of the better looks the Golden Knights have had in this game.
Gage Quinney's had the two best looks of the game. And I guess that's the other factor, Dave. You know, does Gage Quinney enter the equation?
Rempel down the wing. Trying to protect the puck with 10 seconds to go. Korzak along wrist shot. Kekkonen holds it. 6 seconds to go in the period.
Get a look at this again here. Quinney gives it over to Connor, and Connor slides it right back. And Gage has got to lift it, and he can't. It's bang, bang. He's on the bench shaking his head.
He elevates it a little bit, it's in, but it'd be easier said than done in real time.
Vegas born, son of Ken Quinney, a longtime NHLer. Ken also played for the Thunder here in the IHL.
Run clears it. Second period is over. And the Golden Knights down 2-0 after two as the Sharks scored twice in that period.
San Jose 21-14 on the shot clock, and the attempts are well in their favor. They've been better in a lot of areas, and including finish. Quinney had the chance where he came out of the corner. Korzak had a breakaway, and then Quinney there on that bang bang play. Vegas not able to capitalize on any of their chances.
10-8 the shots for San Jose in the period. 21-14 for the game coming up on the Jack in the Box intermission report. Darren will chat with Aiden Hill. You don't see that much, been in the preseason, why not? Aiden Hill played the first half of the game. Darren will visit with him. Moments of the night, sponsored by Finley Chevrolet. Getting ready for the third period. Golden Knights in a 2-0 hole against the San Jose Sharks. Fifth preseason game for the VGK. Had a tough time, Gary, generating consistent offense in this game. Gage Quinney has been noticeable in this game tonight.
Yeah, you know, he's probably tired of hearing about all these other guys that have a chance for this spot. He's been in the organization, been an excellent player in Henderson, and he's been the best player tonight among the skaters for the Golden Knights, and it hasn't really been close. He leads the team with 3 shot attempts, tied with 4 attempts, and he's really had the 2 best opportunities. Drove the net on that one, and then this little give and go with Paul Cotter, real close to finishing and beating Kekkonen. Just a great kick save by Kekkonen to keep Gage off the board.
Yeah, Gage Quinney, we mentioned, terrific year last year, led the Henderson Silver Knights in scoring, and he's had a strong game tonight. But the Golden Knights down 2-0 as you get ready for the third period.
Subaru Drive to the Finish. Our Drive to the Finish is sponsored by Finley Subaru of Las Vegas, home to Subaru for over 50 years. Find a spark. They've got to find some emotion. They've been out battled, outworked. San Jose has wanted it more.
Golden Knights down 2-0. Trying to generate some offense. Been held to 14 shots for the game. 6 in the first period, 8 in the second. Third period underway, and here's Sturm to Zadina. Dancing across the slot. Now Sturm will one-hand it around the net. Philip Zadina bumped by Keegan Colasar, and Carrier starts it out. With Waugh and Colasar up front. Alexander Barabanov around to Kyle Burrows. Here's Sturm at center. Barabanov charging in. Braden Pahal back on it. And around for Cotter. Trying to fight through the hit of Gavanka. Couldn't gain the line, and Bortolo sends it in. Now Quinney losing it to Musty. Ornello fires it in from center ice. Jake Bischoff up ahead. Fraze a little redirect back to Quinney. Quinney trying to make his way up the wall. And Musty has it. Eklund at center. Angle on the play by Korzak. That allows Quinney to pick up the loose puck. Cotter tips it down the ice. He'll wave the icing, so Leon Kamanka back on it. Kamanka back in the spring was going to sign a 4-year deal to return to his native Germany. Not long after that, he got traded to San Jose by Winnipeg and decided to make a go of it still in North America.
You know, he wouldn't play for the Jets if he stayed in that organization. He wouldn't be in their top six. He's got a chance to crack the lineup here in San Jose.
Rempel down the wing, taken out of the play by McDonald. May have taken an errant stick. Morelli. And now Ty Emberson comes away with it, but lost it. Puck around to Cormier on the wing. He'll push it down a little further. And Emberson starts it out with the Sharks. Lead pass jumped off the stick of Lindblom. McDonald gives chase ahead of Demick. To center. Gary able to bump Carpenter off the puck. Gary in deep now against Thrun. Carpenter. Olisar pries it out of there. Hutton pinching in. Bailey got there a stride ahead of him. And now Waugh in the mix. Waugh trying to feed it down to Carrier. Thrun jams it up the wall. And Giovanni Smith clears it. Carrier back the other way, feeds it into the offensive end. Run took a hit from Kolesar to play it around the wall. Carpenter shovels it out. We'll wave the icing late. Braden Pahal back on it. Under some heat, able to spin away from Smith. Good work to maintain possession. Good poise by Pahal. Quinney from his knees to move it to Bischoff. It glances off his stick. Back into the offensive zone, Sturm to Zadina. Kanishov keeps it moving. There's Gavanka across. Kanishov along a wrist shot, missed on the far side, and Cotter deflects it out. A penalty here behind the play. Going to be on San Jose. So,
San Jose minor
Golden Knights.
Number 18.
Get to the power play. We'll take a look at our next gen stats sponsored by America First Credit Union. You know, Gary, think back to our open tonight. We highlighted four players for the Golden Knights among their forwards battling for a roster spot. These four have been quiet in this game.
Yeah, only one shot amongst the whole group. Paul Cotter with one. Dorofeev has a couple of attempts. Brisson's done nothing. Cotter has the one shot, the one attempt, and Comtois generated nothing as well.
There's your penalty, Zadina, for the chop on Bischoff.
Knocked the stick out of Bischoff's hands. Can't do that.
Power play number three for the Golden Knights.
San Jose Valley,
trying to get on the board. The wall line with Hutton and Cormier out there. Puck loose. And Hutton will circle back. Waugh tried to tip that in but missed it. So it's an icing. While on the power play for Vegas.
Well, one of the Quinn things that David Quinn is well known for is he gets effort out of this group. And that's reflected in their ability to kill penalties. There's not a lot of high-end players right now with the organization. They're on their way, but in the interim he's going to get them to work, and we've seen that firsthand tonight. Vegas has generated very little on the power play tonight.
Yeah, we saw this, Gary, when the Golden Knights opened the preseason in San Jose knocked off the Golden Knights in that game. And you know, Shane and I were talking about that night. It is the preseason, and I understand all that, but if you're on the San Jose side of things,
yeah,
you want to build a new culture within your team, you need to get positive results. Preseason or not, beat the defending cup champs earlier, and they're up 2-0 in the third period tonight.
Well, you know, in our conversation with David Quinn, he talked about how there were two very different training camps at preseasons.
Cormier lets it rip, and that missed the net.
Unfolding in San Jose and in Vegas. And, you know, Bruce Cassidy is, you can't get too wound up at this point in time. These guys just took you to the Stanley Cup. You have to trust them. And on the other side in San Jose, a bunch of people fighting for jobs, for opportunities, for careers.
Half a minute to go on the power play for the Golden Knights. They'll get a change in personnel. Korzak. Lead pass to Cotter. He sends it in. Thrun giving chase. Rempel providing some heat. Thrun stays with it. Korzak gloves it. Jackinen plays that away. So inside the final 10 seconds of the man advantage. And Bischoff turns it up ice. He'll gun it in. No shots for the Golden Knights on that power play. Korzak's wrist shot block came right back to him. Here's Quinney with a backhand feed around the wall. Bischoff down a little further. Quinney got knocked down by Zadina. Oh, check it out. Bischoff did. Now off ice, Barabanov. Driving wide, pulls up, feeds it in cross. And the redirect missed the net off the stick of Musty.
Yeah, that hit stung Bischoff. I'm not sure he's right.
Hanging in there right now, the play in the Vegas end of the rink. Musty dancing back to the blue line, down the slot, off the board low. He wanted it for the one timer, but the pass is a little bit too far in front of him. And Rempel banks it out. Icing though on the Golden Knights, and that group, including Bischoff, he's gonna have to stay.
He's grimacing. I think they're gonna let, they might let him jump off the ice. He gets walloped here by Zadina. He comes up at the last second too. Now they're gonna let Jake hop off the ice. And he'll be replaced by Leighton Ahak.
We'll look at Jake Bischoff, who battled a lot of injury over the last few years to get back and healthy and playing. And an injury that's similar to Eric Hollis a few years ago. So much work to get back. Like he'll try to shake this off on the bench. Here's Comtois. Demick funnels it down the ice. Gonna be another penalty here on San Jose. The Golden Knights were given a shot after that power play ended. It's the only shot for either team so far in the period. Now the Golden Knights will go right back to work on the man advantage. It hurts to win. The official book from the Vegas Golden Knights Stanley Cup Championship. Pre-order yours today or pick up a copy soon at the official team stores.
The interference. Giovanni Smith rubs out Paul Cotter. He's, the puck is nowhere near them. Well, had moved on well from the point of contact, and Smith decided to still finish his check. Sits for two.
Golden Knights did not muster much on the last power play. See if this one, they can change that. Brisson to move it down to Kolesar. Brisson behind the net now. Off to Waugh. Wrist shot blocked by Sturm and cleared by Zadina. Ben Hutton back on it. To the red line. Waugh denied to the blue line by Eklund. And an offside on the Golden Knights.
Ben, I think, thought maybe I should dump it in, but then he didn't. And that little pause, that little hitch, sent a couple of his line mates offside. Right here, he gains the red line. He makes the pass to Carrier, and it's for Dewa. And had no chance to succeed.
Now the guys are talking during periods about the Golden Knights and trying to generate some urgency and get to their game.
Yeah.
They're still trying to do both. Dorofeev down low and put it on net. Kakinen, who's been not tremendously busy tonight, but he has made some quality saves. A couple of point blank chances on Gage Quinney. Caden Korzak had a break in the second period. And he turned away. A nice glove save on Nick Waugh in the second. 16 for 16 in all for Kakinen. Korzak across. Rempel down the middle. Partially blocked by Emberton.
Ooh.
Now Lindblom has caught Dorofeev in an awkward position. Dorofeev up. Looks to be all right. Korzak out top. Rempel for Cotter. Wrist shot up over the net. Rempel zips it across. Cotter couldn't quite keep that alive, and the Golden Knights will clear the zone. Comtois down the wing, sends it across, but out of the reach of Cotter. And the puck cleared by Sturm.
Yeah, too many plays that it's easy from up here that look like they're not going to click, and then result in losing the puck.
One shot on that power play for the Golden Knights. They're 0 for 4 on the evening. Morelli wheels it into the corner. Demick trying to center out of the reach of Fraze. And Eklund on the move for San Jose. There's Sturm with a rush shot and a save made by Thompson on the first shot of the period for the Sharks. And a good one for Nico Sturm.
That was a heavy shot.
Alpahal flips it out. Sturm pressured by Fraze. Demick digs it out. Carey trying to break to the net. And had it knocked off his stick. He finishes his hit on Eklund. Guerrier back the other way. Wide, driving wide on McDonald, and his shot turned away by Kakinen. He's past the halfway point of the third period. Puck in deep. Cormier gloves it. He was under some heat from Zetterlund. Olisar with a couple of shots. They're going to call him.
Yeah.
From Musty. They'll let him get away with the first one, but not the second.
That was a man hitting a boy there, David.
And Olisar to the box. The first one they let go. And he kept going, and he's to the box.
Broadcast tonight. Shane Naughty with Derek Englund. Wave, gentlemen. Wave. With Ashley Weiss in section 117. Ashley's hosting the pregame, the intermissions, and the postgame show, allowing me to be downstairs. And there's Gary Lawless alongside Dave Gosher, who's at communicating with all his fans. Now, everybody's in a different spot except for Dave.
Yeah.
Why do you get to stick in your regular duty?
It's a valid point. I don't know what else. I can't do much else. That's why.
Is that the reason why?
I can't. I am very, very limited. Gary's a lot closer to the ice in this perch than the usual radio perch where he's in Reno.
I thought it was because you're so valuable, you bring people together and you hold it together.
I like your explanation better than mine, which is
Reno.
I can't do much else.
Yep.
How is Reno?
I like Reno. Great town.
There for a little bit this summer. That's fine. Liked it.
I was talking to Gary.
Oh, okay. But I still like it anyway, for the record. Oh, like a bunch of misfit toys here. Everyone's in different spots. Golden Knights down a couple here in the third. Shorthanded for the third time of the game. San Jose's 1 for 2. Arbanov trying to center it. And Carey trying to fire that out. And Zetterlund did a good job to tie up his stick. Arbanov wrist shot blocked. Look out, that caught Bischoff up high. A couple of rough shifts in a row for Jake. Now Zetterlund in tight. Shot blocked by Pahal. That was a good setup for Zetterlund. Barabanov, or check it out. Peterson now to Zetlin. Off to Barabanov. Zadina and the McDonald who had the power play goal earlier. Zadina's drive blocked by Bischoff. Chips it up the wall, and Waugh backhands it down the ice.
Jake's going to need a couple ice bags.
Yeah. 40 seconds to go on the power play. Coming up on 8 minutes to go in the game.
Soft is not something you equate with Jake Bischoff. He's as hard as they come. Tough guy.
Drunn gains the line. Out Bailey. Bortolo dishing it back out top. William Eklund. Bortolo to Eklund. Couple of steps in. That duo combined for a real nice goal earlier tonight. Winnie's good read. Eklund pass tips it out.
Jake, Gage showing you his intelligence and then his speed. He got down the ice pretty quickly there.
Eklund back deep in his own end. San Jose did not land a shot of the man advantage. Both their goals coming in the second from Thomas Bortolo and Jacob McDonald. Kolesar on the wall starts it out. Hutton into the zone will back in. Then, and if you're just joining us, the Golden Knights splitting goaltenders tonight. Aiden Hill played the first half of the game, allowed one goal on 15 shots. Logan Thompson in since then. He's allowed one goal on 8. Carpenter nudges it towards the corner. Comtois turned it over right to Smith. And Thompson gloves it. Not a good giveaway for Max Comtois, but Logan Thompson bails him out with 6:37 to go. Of course, in October, the Fortress will be buzzing and includes can't miss games like the raising of the championship banner. Also a Western Conference rematch and Nevada Day matinee all coming up here at T-Mobile Arena. Scan the QR code to get your tickets.
Comtois just inexplicably flips that one right out into Bruce Cassidy. Calls that the good ice, and it goes right into the good ice that they want to protect. And it's a quick shot on Logan Thompson.
You pat ice in your own zone, right?
Yeah.
Not good. Arbanov looking to move it. Sturm racing in. I go wide on Korzak. Good work by Caden to knock Sturm down. Ahak will start it out. Here's Demick to center. A little short feed to Ahak. Trying to fight his way to the net. He got bothered by Burrows, who's able to take care of business defensively. Now Barabanov has it. Bischoff backhands it in deep. Golden Knights have been shut out once in the exhibition season in their history. It was in San Jose 2 years ago. They lost 4-0. Aiden Hill pitched the shutout for the Sharks that night. A whistle with 5.5 to go now in the third period of the Fortress. Aiden Hill and his teammates down by 2.
Casino Resort and Yamava Resort and Casino. Bruce Cassidy big on respecting the process. So we'll be interested to hear what he has to say after this one on the Findlay Automotive post-game show. 5.5 minutes plus 2 more preseason games to work out all the kinks. And by that final game in LA, our broadcast crew should be back in order in their normal spots. But in the meantime, Dave, Shane wanted me to let you know that he misses you very much. I can barely keep a straight face as I look at him and say that one.
There's not a chance on earth he would ever say that. No way. I'm just happy he hasn't dozed off up there. It is a side workstation for the night. He seemed conscious. We had him on camera earlier, so that's a plus. And we'll all be back in our spots, we think, for that final exhibition game in LA on Saturday. And then our first broadcast of the regular season will be in San Jose against the Sharks coming up a week Thursday. Bortolo tips it in. Korzak. And now Hutton. Carrier on the wall. And Hutton jams it around the Korzak up ahead to Kolesar, who tips it out. And you would think, Gary, now you're getting down to the dwindling days of training camp. And Bruce Cassidy's talked about these last couple of games coming up Thursday, Saturday. You're going to see much more of what you'd expect the Golden Knights would start with coming up here a week from tonight.
Yeah, it's time to get the team game into shape. Bahal is not happy with Jovani Smith.
They're both going to go. Smith's been involved all night.
Yep.
Bahal fought more than a handful of times in the American League last year.
So penalties with 4:25 to go now.
Our Toyota instant replay. Southern Nevada Toyota dealers instant replay. We see Jovani Smith and Bahal whacking, and then Smith throws a left and then kind of yanks the jersey at Bahal. No harm done, but there are fouls. And Smith is done for the night, it looks like. Might have got something extra.
Well, that's it for him.
Yeah. I think Kyle Raymond and Jordan Samuel Thomas are deciding that they don't want this to turn into something untoward, so they'll give him the gate. Here's Kyle Raymond.
Pelly's on the play. Number 54 from San Jose has a 2-minute minor for high sticking, 2-minute minor for roughing, and a 10-minute misconduct. Vegas has a 94, has 2 minutes for slashing, 2-minute penalty on the clock for San Jose. 5-on-4.
Another power play for the Golden Knights.
Well, Smith with 14 minutes in penalties. Done for the evening. Golden Knights to the power play for the fifth time. Musty will serve the penalty to Jovani Smith. A wad line with Brisson and Hutton on the power play.
Seen this grouping a few times. No success as of yet. Enough time to make it interesting, Dave.
Golden Knights haven't landed a shot on goal in over 5 minutes.
That won't get it done.
No. The third power play of the third period. Brisson. Now Eklund on the wall. Trying to fight his way out of the zone. Sturm tips it towards the Vegas end. Kolesar hustling back, and now Hutton.
Penalties to Vegas, number 94.
He'll feed it in around the wall. All the way around by Kolesar and back out.
Ben Hutton. Maybe the best thing that he does is you can't tell if he's played 10 in a row or if he hasn't.
Rick centering pass, Connor to Rempel. Gackenen took care of it. And a whistle with 3.5 left.
Some good stick handling by Paul Connor, and then
Vegas bench minor penalty. Too many men on the ice.
Yeah, Golden Knights still have 6 skaters out there while on the power play.
Maybe that's why it looks so good.
Kaapo Kähkönen has turned aside everything he's seen tonight.
Bruce Cassidy is, I wouldn't think he's doing a slow burn, but he's seen enough of this.
Yeah.
He's ready to get out of this one, have a practice tomorrow, and then get his regulars going. And I would imagine that there won't be any Al Pacino any given Sunday speeches, but probably let's start to play our game, guys. Let's start to get this dialed in.
And it is a delicate balance, right? You're playing preseason games right now, and back in the middle of June, you were playing in the highest possible intensity games you could have, all the way to the top of the mountain. You've said, though, these preseason games do mean different things to different players, especially if you're trying to make the team out of camp. Highlighted some of the players in the running at both forward position and on defense.
Not sure how many more cracks they will get at it. Two preseason games to go. The Golden Knights did start to dwindle down their roster a little bit more and get to what they hope will be as close to their opening night lineup as they can. So not sure of the status of Zach Whitecloud, out for the rest of the preseason. Here's Cotter in deep. He'll start it out. So 4-on-4 for the next 15 seconds, and San Jose will go to the power play. Bischoff up ice. He'll fire it in. Waugh had a trickle off his stick. Look out, Musty on the move. Chased by Waugh. Good work by Waugh, hustling back. Get a piece of Musty. Now the centering pass to Peterson. I think he stepped on the puck. Run for Burrows. Power play for San Jose. 1 for 3 tonight. And Musty holding. Out high to Thrun. Now Musty for the one timer to save Thompson. And the loose puck. Ahak trying to move it out. Peterson in deep. And a funnel that through. Bischoff blocks it. But Thrun has it out top and around the horn to Barabanov. First shot from Thrun blocked by Waugh. Penalty about to expire. Barabanov fanned on the one timer. Had a lot of net to shoot out, but he broke his stick in two. Dorofeev was serving the penalty. He's out.
Geez, if Barabanov gets a hold of that one, it might be 3-0. He had a lot of net deep. Good movement by the Sharks.
All back to 5-on-5 now. Korzak wires it in. 2-0 San Jose, getting late. 1 minute to go in the third period is sponsored by Credit One Bank. Thompson's on his way to the bench for the extra attacker. McDonald up the glass, off the glove of Korzak, and into the San Jose bench with 37.2 to go. And we'll see if the Golden Knights can put together a little something here down the stretch, Gary. If they don't, they'll move to 1-4 in the preseason. I would say this. I could not tell you the preseason record of any team in the history of sports.
No, it's immaterial. So it's about getting ready for game one, and you know, the Golden Knights went 13-5 to start last year, and that was a big reason why they won the Pacific and the West.
13-2.
13-2.
Right, out of the gates.
Yeah.
And then down the stretch, what, 22-4-5. Yeah.
Yep.
So great start.
Bookends.
Great ending of the regular year and the ultimate ending of the playoffs. So the Golden Knights with the extra attacker, and Hutton will feed it in. Pile up in deep. Carrier trying to emerge with it. Burrows double team. Carrier around the wall for Korzak. Waugh for the one timer. Ripped it wide. Comes out in front. Swept to the wall. Hutton keeps it in with 5 seconds. Across for Brisson. Shot blocked. Carpenter in the corner, and that's it. It's a 2-0 win for the Sharks in Vegas. Kaapo Kähkönen with the 18-save shutout. Sharks take both games from the Golden Knights in the exhibition season. 2 goals in the second were enough to do it for San Jose tonight. Our game changer of the night is sponsored by Comprehensive Cancer Centers.
Kaapo Kähkönen, he 18 saves and 3 really good ones. 2 on Gage Quinney, 1 on Nick Waugh, and another on, make it 4, another on Caden Korzak. He was, there were some opportunities. Golden Knights unable to capitalize on any of those chances. And the Sharks will get on their plane and head home feeling pretty good.
They'll have one more preseason game in Salt Lake against the Kings Thursday. For the VGK, 2 to go here against Colorado Thursday and then in LA on Saturday afternoon to wrap up the exhibition schedule. 2-0 Sharks, your final tonight as we send it back upstairs to Ashley.
Yeah, thank you very much, Dave. Like you said, not the result the Golden Knights were looking for here in preseason game number 5, but we still have plenty to talk about on the Finley Automotive Group post-game show. We'll take a look at the Finley Automotive Player of the Night. We'll hear from the Golden Knights locker room as well as head coach Bruce Cassidy, and we'll bring Derek England and Shane Knighty back in the conversation. Stick with us. We'll be back in just a couple.